So we are going to do a wonderful thing today, and it is Mexican hand wraps. Now, it's a little bit different. We're going to use flour tortillas. And now, the caveman's home tonight, and he came home sick. So I'm gonna make him exactly what he wants, which is steak soft tacos. Yes, you heard me. But Barbie, that's not vegan. Don't worry, I got you. We're gonna do some oil in my pan, and I'm gonna make my not meat meat. Loving it. So I'm gonna start with the boneless. Of course they're boneless, they're vegan, they're soy crumbles. So I'm gonna start with opening the package. Now I'm not sponsored by Gardein, but you know, I should be. So I'm gonna start with a full sweet chopped onion, putting it down in just the saucepan with the oil. And Campari tomato. Just give it a lot of liquid down in the pot so that it can simmer and take on all the flavors of everything I put in. It's so good. Now, I have three baby bella mushrooms that I have chopped. Putting them down in there, and about a little over, I don't know, what would you call that? About a third of a jalapeno. So there we go. Going to give it a stir around.
And then now, you're going to use the
knife. I'm going to, well, I already used the knife.
Oh, I thought you were going to use the knife in the pan.
Not in the pan. You never use a knife in the pan because it cuts the surface.
I use that.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. So, we're going to move it towards center. Mix it around a little nicely. You are juicing everywhere, child.
I'm sorry.
All right, put a teaspoon of the coarse salt. You are tomatoing everywhere. You're like a tomato sprinkler. Pepper. And here we go.
You want the rest?
No, I'm good. You start it, you eat it. Here we go. Hey guys, I'm back. So I have been working down the vegetables. And they are smelling so good, so good. Nice and simmery. I've got them down on low heat now. And I am going to add in my veggie crumbles. Now, only about, I don't know, half to three-fourths of a cup, because we've got a lot of other things that are going in the hand wraps. We don't need a huge amount of soy product. And of course, we've got all the vegetables that are simmering and sauteing there together. So, now about the seasoning. I'm going to use about a tablespoon of aminos. I'm going to use about half a teaspoon of paprika. I'm gonna use like two hits of chili powder, two shakes of ginger, one of curry, one of onion powder. Now I'm gonna do two shakes of garlic powder, but I'm also gonna use some minced garlic and about a teaspoon of minced garlic. Now I like to use the minced garlic in some things instead of the fresh garlic, really because it gives a nice flavor that does not have to be boiled or cooked as long. The fresh garlic really needs to be processed in with what you're cooking to get a nice even flavor. When you have a minced product that comes already minced, it's a lot more liquid and it's a lot more that'll dissolve kind of in your pan. So just so you know. So notice how it's really absorbing all of those liquids and flavors. Oh, I could just eat it straight on chips. And actually, speaking of chips, this is a really great way to create a nice, chunky, meat-like substance to go over your nachos. And I'm gonna show you that later. While that's coming back up to temp, I have taken a chunk. So here's the cabbage, here's the, of course, purple cabbage. And I've just shaved off a little bit of the side and I just chopped it into slivers. Now, from here, I'm going to take a fourth of a lime. squeeze it over the top of the lime. I'm going to take and drizzle just that much oil. I'm going to pinch some salt. I'm going to just grab a touch of the minced garlic and two cracks of the pepper. Now I'm just gonna kind of move it around in there and let it kind of coat itself. And we'll give it, you know, 20 or 30 minutes as I'm working on the rest of the hand wraps, just to kind of coat itself and break down a little bit. Now this is, of course, a very, very basic slaw, and it's really delicious to go with, of course, the steak that the caveman wants in his hand wrap tonight, but of course also the vegan meat that we're gonna put in our hand wraps. Now it's super, super cooling, which is counters the spice of our meat. And it just tastes so wonderful. The dogs are fighting to get in. They're already smelling it. It's smelling good. All right, so we set this to the side. Give another stir. And look how wonderful it looks. Now it looks just like ground beef with some vegetables. But it's not, Kavies. We know how good it is. I'm gonna show you some wonderful mango salsa. Mangoes are really in season right now, and I'm gonna show you something that's delicious. Hey guys, now you know this section of the drill. Now I'm going to show you how to make a wonderful mango salsa. Now mangoes are in season right now, and we love to eat them. They're so sweet and wonderful. So I've got my little hand mixer here, and I've got 2, 3 Campari tomatoes. I have got some sections of a full mango. I'm gonna smush them down in there. I have 1/3 of a jalapeno, seeds and all. I'm just gonna continue to smush things down. Now, before I put the last piece of mango in, I'm going to take my handful of cilantro and really push it down into the bottom of my hand mixer, because it's got to, of course, drop up, and then pull apart the last little bit of mango and push it in. It is so good, I know you know. So now I'm going to take about a teaspoon of salt, just table salt, 1, 2 hits of chili powder, 1, 2, 3, 4 hits of garlic, 1, 2 of onion powder, and I have 1/4 of a lime and 1/2 of a lime. So 1/2 of a lime squeezed down over it. Put the lid on. Now, you know, you guys know I love a hand meal, is I can really control the texture of my salsa. So, just after 4 or 5 rounds, we've got some really nice big chunks. So, I'm gonna keep going. Amazing. And it's gonna go right down nicely over those little hand wraps. It's gonna bring out the sweetness of the avocados we're gonna put in and a lot of the lettuces we're gonna put in. Stay tuned, hop back over, I'll show you the steak. Now, before I hop over, the caveman is throwing his steak there on the fire. I tell you, love myself a caveman. But I'm gonna show you how to throw some flour tortillas in the oven to warm up. Now, I do my aluminum foil in kind of a T shape. So I have first and then second, and layer them in a T shape. Now, I spray them all with cooking spray very liberally, and then I kind of make a loose circle with my tortillas and two layers of tortillas. So before I start the second layer, I spray them all with cooking spray and layer the others. There we go. And then layer them again. Spray them again. Now this just gives them some moisture to kind of steam and come up temperature. And I go bottom, side, side, and top. Baking a little packet, and then I put it in a 350 oven, really before it even comes up to temperature, just to kind of steam the tortillas and give them a nice, really soft, lovely, warming taste so that we can, of course, throw everything in. So see you in a sec. Hey, Cavies, I'm back, and the caveman has just pulled the steak off the grill. I have finished up our meat. I just pulled some arugula out of the garden, cut up a nice avocado, and we are ready to plate. So I'm gonna start with the little egg first. Now, I am going to start with cutting the meat on the bias to give them some nice, tender, of course, cuts of meat. Ooh, ugh, it's on my fingers. So I'm going to grab my tortillas that I had in the oven. I'm going to put about two pieces of steak on each one. Now these are for the little egg, so I'm only gonna put some salsa, and that's it for the little egg. And I'm gonna do him two of those. So here we go. And two little pieces of steak. A little bit, ooh, it's hot in my hand. A little bit of salsa. And that's for little egg. Yay! Now, the carnivore is gonna want, of course, a little bit more decadence on his flavors. So I have his, woo, they're super hot. Some higher up, woo, hot, hot, hot. I'm going to start with a little bit of beans. Then layer in some of his steak. Woo, pull it off. It's not cutting. There we go. A steak. I'm going to put in a little bit of slaw, some cheese. They tell me everything's better with cheese. I'm not really sure. Some arugula, a couple of pieces of arugula. And now he likes a salsa, the spicy salsa that I make. So here we go. Here's what I'm gonna give to the caveman. So that's one of his tacos. And I'm just gonna do a couple more. Now for me, I am going to do a nice layer of the beans. I'm going to put in a spoon or two of the fake meat of the soy crumbles. Lots of arugula, because I love it nice and spicy. I'm going to do a couple of pieces of the slaw. Plenty of that wonderful mango dressing, and I'm going to throw in a mango slice, and of course, I'm going to squeeze a little bit of lime. So here's mine. Yum! So here we go. Now I'm gonna finish plating it up. So from my family to your family, from my cave to your home, like, share, subscribe, and I hope you enjoyed this episode of Barbie and the Caveman. See you soon.